Hello, everyone. Welcome to Stained Glass. I'm Shelby Margaret Hageman. The students call me Miss Margaret, but you can call me Shelby or Miss Margaret. Either way is totally fine. A little bit about me. I teach photography and stained glass, and I absolutely love art and any kind of art medium. And trying new things, exploring different things through art. And also seeing a lot of different other people's perspectives that they share through art. And I love sharing that with students. I also think that art right now is really important, more now than ever, especially because we all kind of need some way to be creative in our lives right now. I personally have seen it in other people and myself personally that art really can help people get through difficult times, whether you're using it as a way of self-expression or just as a way to focus on something positive when there's a lot of negative happening. I find art to be really important. So it's something that I am trying to really emphasize with the students right now. As far as my own personal artwork, I love portraiture and portrait photography. I also do a lot of gardening in my spare time. This here is me with my little pumpkin family that I harvested last year. Soon going to harvest my pumpkins from this year. We've been working in stained glass with some alternative types of art materials. We will be using glass soon, but for right now we have been creating found mosaics with a variety of different objects that the students have found. And so it's been open to use just about any kind of materials for this project, and the students have come up with some really creative ideas. So anything from yarn to things like little pebbles, paper, crumpled up paper even, lots of different materials have been showing up in all our students' work. Even some of them have been surprising me. Some kids wanted to use Legos and create a mosaic that way. And this has given us an opportunity to explore lots of different potential ways to create a mosaic and look at what makes a mosaic a mosaic. We will be using glass soon though. We're going to be starting our next project in a couple weeks that is going to be an actual glass mosaic, like these two on the left here. And so that will be really exciting because we actually get to use glass. It does come with some safety concerns since it's something that's usually done in the classroom where I can monitor students and make sure that they are being safe with glass. However, it is something that's going to be made a little safer by the fact that I am cutting the glass. I'm pre-cutting all the little pieces. So students are primarily using those as a material to arrange in their design. From there, we're also going to be creating some 3D mosaics. These are a couple of examples here. And then eventually we will get into fusing or the melting of glass in a kiln. And so we will be using glass soon. A few little important information things. So I do accept any late work. So if your student hasn't turned in a project out of any of our previous projects, they still have the opportunity to do so. Both you and them can check on Schoology to see what they still need to turn in. There is no penalty for turning in any late work. As far as checking grades, the most up-to-date grades are on Schoology. You can check parent view for the grades. Sometimes they do end up being a little delayed though. I put them originally in Schoology and it's supposed to put them directly into Synergy or parent view. but it does have a tendency to have a few little technology issues and become a little delayed. So the most up-to-date is on Schoology, but on Parent View, it should be accurate as well. Since we are going to be using Glass and other materials that your students do not have currently, we will be having some days, primarily on Wednesdays in a couple weeks, that is going to be material pickup days for that Glass. So since we are dealing with a variety of different types of materials, there's going to be a little bit of back and forth with different types of materials. So there will be upcoming days to pick up materials. I will send out an email to you and all the students about that when that happens. Another thing that we have going on all semester is a project that is a virtual art museum. So in a normal situation, students will have the opportunity to go visit an actual art museum and look at art and compare things and discuss the art that they're seeing. However, that can be done virtually. A lot of art museums have their work posted online or have museum tours that students can visit virtually on their websites. So that is always an option. Another option, if students or you are willing, there are lots of outdoor type art exhibits like the Olympic Sculpture Park. I've had quite a few students ask about that, and that is something that can be used for it. But again, that is something that is just based on your own comfort level. It can just be done virtually on these virtual art museum tours. But that is something that's going to be a semester long project. So students need to visit two museums and fill out the assignment that goes with it. So that is due technically at the very end of the semester, but it's something that can be done at any point. If you ever need to contact me about anything, my email address is shegman@nsd.org. Please feel free to email me if you have any questions about anything regarding stained glass or if anything comes up. If you ever need to talk to me about anything more than something simple in an email, you can always book a Zoom appointment with me at shelbymargarethegeman.youcanbook.me, and that will show you all of my available times that I can meet, and it will schedule a Zoom meeting with me. So feel free to contact me about anything, and I look forward to seeing more of your students' work.